Hi everyone, my name is Vladimir Dvorkin, and today I'm going to talk about differentially private optimal power flow for distribution grids. We consider distribution grid as a directed graph that consists of nodes and edges. At every node, we have a load and a local generation, and the system can be characterized by power flows and voltages associated with every node. And to optimize this graph, in a least cost manner, we solve a distribution optimal power flow problem. And from a privacy standpoint, it really makes sense to consider OPF problem as a mapping from universe of load data sets to say power flow solutions, right? And what is interesting that whenever we record a change in a data set, this change will translate into a change of power flows, hence exposing the activity of grid customers through state measurements, power flows, and voltages. Alternatively, we can think of the same problem in this geometric form. We have some objective function to minimize, which is dispatch cost, and we would like to attain least cost solution given the feasible region of the problem. For this specific case, the optimal solution lies here. And what we know in the privacy literature is that whenever we want to obfuscate data sets from the outcome of a computation from this value, we just need to add some randomized noise to the result of this computation. And if we directly apply zero mean noise to the solution, we'll see that the half of the probability density of the randomized outcomes will be outside the feasible region, which renders the solution impractical. And in this work, we find we develop the means to compute alternative nominal solution F2, such that when we randomize it, when we add some random noise to the solution, we can guarantee that the majority of this density is located within the feasible region of the problem. Right, so we can provide privacy for loads through randomization and also ensure feasibility of distribution OPF. But the question is how to find this nominal solution F2. And to find the solution, we propose the following perturbation strategy for generators and local DRs and substation. For privacy, on the privacy side, we would like that to obfuscate the load at this node, we need to make sure that the power flow here or the current is distributed according to the distribution of some zero mean random variable Xi. Since it's a state variable, we cannot just directly alter it. So instead, we can perturb the generation in the upstream part of the network with this random variable Xi and counterbalance this perturbation, like proportionally, like in this case, with the rest of the generators in the downstream, such that having this balanced perturbation, we ensure that the power flow randomized according to distribution of random variable Xi. And more formally, we define the following randomized policies that are a fine function of the perturbation. And then we introduce, so here we have some nominal component, some random component, where this is optimization variable to be optimized. And this T parameter relates to topology, whether it's in the upstream or downstream of the network. And then we introduce additional constraints on recourse to make sure that perturbation from upstream are counterbalanced by the response in the downstream of the network. And what is interesting is that through AC power flow equations, we can express the power flow, like active power flow in this branch, as a function of this perturbation and generator decisions. It means that there must be some means to optimize this generator policy, anticipating a projection on the power flows to achieve privacy. And we indeed do so using the following chance constraint program that takes this generator policies and expression of state variables as affine functions and minimizes the expected dispatch cost subject to probabilistic constraints that require OPF feasibility with very high probability, 1 minus eta, where eta is a very small parameter. So say equations must satisfy with probability 99%. And we provide certain performance guarantees for this mechanism. I don't have time to talk about all of them, but the most important one is, of course, privacy guarantee. So what we show in the paper is that when we smartly calibrate the distribution of this noise through parameterization of covariance matrix sigma, we optimize a fine perturbation policies for generators, such that we have optimized value for the nominal value of OPF variables and recourse, and it remains to sample a single perturbation from the known distribution to obtain a private OPF result. Right. More strictly, in the paper, we show that when this perturbation-based normal distribution, where diagonal elements of the sigma are base epsilon delta differential privacy parameters according to this formula, and to make any adjacent loads indistinguishable, like loads that are different from original one, let's say in a range plus minus beta, then we just need to parameterize diagonal elements of covariant matrix with these parameters here, then we will obtain epsilon delta differentially privacy, which means that power flow solutions, randomized power flow solutions on original data set and some beta adjacent data set will be very similar to each other, but also when we sample OPF solution from the randomized outcomes, we will ensure feasibility with very high probability. To show how it works in practice, consider this 15 bus radial distribution network with 14 customers and assume that you can have access to voltage and current tests to monitor activity of grid loads. And just for example, take the customer at this node 7 that has very atypical load profiles that consist in three components. The first component, like a large one with these two peaks on this graph, there is also a medium component and a very small but high frequency component here as well. And what we'd like to do, we'd like to take this load profile, make it indistinguishable from any other load profile in the range of plus minus beta. Right. So when this beta amounts to zero, so there is no privacy requirements enforced, you can see that the power flow in this H directly exposes this load profile. But as we increase beta privacy parameter, what happens is that we add calibrated noise to generation such that the power flow in this line randomizes. And now, when we want to make this load indistinguishable from any other load in the range plus minus 70 kilowatts, we will have this noise that obfuscates this small high frequency component. As we increase beta further, we can hide the presence of this medium periodic component. And of course, as we more increase beta, we turn the power flow in this H as basically into white noise. And important is that all these perturbations are accommodated in a physical manner by redispatching local generation, right? And we input the same load profile all the time, but we obtain randomized power flows in the networks. And a similar picture is for voltages. So the definition of privacy we use based epsilon delta definition of differential privacy, where epsilon is a privacy loss and delta is a probability of failure. These two privacy parameters are also important to calibrate to ensure strong guarantees. So for example, here on the left, we have power flow random distribution that is induced on three different data sets and privacy parameters are weak. And specifically probability, delta probability of failure is as much as 75%, which makes these three distributions indistinguishable between each other. Hence, we can see the difference in data sets. But as we tune privacy parameters, and for example, we make a probability of a failure, this delta parameter to be at most 7%, then we see that the distributions of random OPF outcomes of three data sets are very similar. It means that when we observe the sample from the blue distribution, we cannot tell from what distribution it came from blue, from pink or green one, which means that we cannot tell what data set is used in computation, hence ensuring privacy in a very mathematically rigorous way. In conclusion, I'd like to say that with this paper, we proposed the first centralized privacy preserving mechanism to ensure privacy of grid loads in operational routines of distribution grid operators. We In the paper, we show a lot of extensions to what I've been talking about. So aside from feasibility guarantees and privacy guarantees, we also provide means to control optimality loss, like the increase in dispatch cost induced due to noise and computations. And we also enable to minimize the variability of OPF outcomes that tends to increase as we use more privacy preserving perturbations to optimal power flow problem. And I also would like to highlight that we made the code open source, and you can easily replicate our results just following this link. And it's also, we encourage you to read the full paper available in transactions on power systems. Thank you very much for your attention.